Notice that you haven't been hearing much about black holes crashing into each other recently? That's because the world's most sensitive gravitational wave hunters have been offline for the last year. Well, they're back now with enough upgrades that they should be capable of finding a black hole merger every week, not to mention more colliding neutron stars and maybe, just maybe, black holes eating neutron stars. The National Science Foundation's Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory, or LIGO, is a triumph of modern engineering. It has two detectors, one in Washington State and another in Louisiana. They're joined by the Virgo instrument in Italy to provide a three-dimensional view of the universe in gravitational waves. The detectors are built in the shape of an L, with laser beams that bounce back and forth down the arms and then come together and recombine. When a gravitational wave passes through one of the facilities, the distance traveled along one of the arms changes slightly so that the lasers recombine in a way that's different and detectable. LIGO first went operational in 2002, and over the course of the next 8 years, it didn't detect a single gravitational wave. For the next few years, the instruments were significantly upgraded and began operations again in 2014. Finally, on September 14th, 2015, LIGO detected the first collision of two black holes. During this extreme event, a black hole with 29 times the mass of the Sun crashed into another black hole with 36 times the mass of the Sun. Three times the mass of the Sun were converted directly into gravitational waves, which rippled out into space. These gravitational waves traveled through the universe for 1.3 billion light years, eventually passing over the LIGO instruments. In Italy, the European Gravitational Observatory's Virgo instrument came online in 2007 and was significantly upgraded in 2016. Together, LIGO and Virgo have detected a total of 9 mergers of black holes. In 2017, LIGO and Virgo together detected for the first time ever the gravitational waves from merging neutron stars, a kilonova. To celebrate the direct detection of gravitational waves, Rainer Weiss, Barry Barish, and Kip Thorne were awarded the 2017 Nobel Prize in Physics. The second observing run was a tremendous success, but the team decided to shut it down to make even more improvements. On August 25th, 2017, LIGO was turned off to begin almost 2 years of upgrades and improvements. On April 1st, 2019, a newly upgraded LIGO instrument came online, bristling with enough sensitivity that experimenters think that it should turn up a black hole merger every week, as well as many more colliding neutron stars. Europe's Virgo instrument was upgraded as well. So what's been updated? The first improvement is that the power of the laser shooting down the arms has been doubled, allowing any change in distance to be measured more precisely. This makes the instrument's detectors more sensitive to gravitational waves. Mirrors at both locations for LIGO were upgraded, with 5 of the 8 mirrors swapped out with better versions. This was a tricky operation with engineers breaking the fibers holding the mirrors so that they could replace them. They implemented a new technique to reduce levels of quantum noise called squeezing. Photons randomly fluctuate, making it harder to measure them. Engineers figured out how to shift the uncertainty, making it harder to measure their amplitude, but easier to measure their timing, which is what these detections depend on. This method was developed for a gravitational wave detector in Australia, which was able to remove the quantum background noise of the universe by a factor of 2. This allows the faint signal of gravitational waves to stand out. Significant improvements have been made to the Virgo facility in Europe, doubling its sensitivity, increasing the volume of the universe that it can scan by a factor of 8. With this increased power, Virgo, together with the twin LIGO instruments, can better triangulate the position in the sky that gravitational waves are coming from. One of the most significant improvements in this run is the non-stop observations. For an entire year, the LIGO and the Virgo facilities will run 24/7, continuously scanning for black hole mergers, and then publishing all their detections immediately out onto the internet. With these improvements, LIGO and Virgo will be able to detect neutron star mergers out to 550 million light years away, more than 190 million light years farther than before. At the end of 2019, the Japanese Kagra instrument will join the LIGO-Virgo network, adding another set of eyes on the sky. Well, we're about a month into this new observing run. Any discoveries? Yes, indeed, and we'll get to that in a second, but first I'd like to thank Hugh Parker, John Hyatt, Anthony Jacobs, Gary Anderson, William Jones, and the rest of our 802 patrons for their generous support. They contribute so that you can see these videos and we can make them available to anyone who wants to learn about space. Join our community at patreon.com/universetoday and get in on the action. Now that we're all accustomed to the idea that black holes with dozens of times the mass of the sun are crashing into each other all around us, astronomers want to observe them as quickly as possible. Instead of sitting on their detections for weeks to carefully examine the data, the system automatically watches for any significant events picked up by their detectors. Astronomers are alerted immediately so they can go and make follow-up observations right away. The LIGO-Virgo team will double-check the detections as quickly as possible and either confirm or retract them later. I'll run through a few announcements which have been provisionally detected. Now, they might get retracted over the coming weeks, and if so, forget I ever told you. The first new gravitational wave detected from merging black holes happened on April 8th, 2019. Another was detected on April 12th, and then another on April 21st. On April 24th, astronomers detected what they think is a second merger between neutron stars, another kilonova event. And most excitingly, on April 26th, LIGO and Virgo announced an unusual burst of waves, with the tantalizing possibility that they've seen a black hole merging with a neutron star for the first time. It occurred 1.2 billion light years away, and right now, astronomers from around the world are turning their telescopes to see the afterglow of this immense merger. Still on their to-do list, astronomers are hopeful they'll see continuous gravitational waves from spinning neutron stars which aren't lined up with their axes. We're about 4 weeks into the new observing run, and it looks like the system has turned up, on average, one new merger a week, right on schedule. Now, if you want to watch the discoveries unfold in real time, I'll put a link to the open public alerts in the show notes. And you can even get an app so your phone will let you know when the catastrophic collision between gigantic black holes millions of light years away just happened. That's handy. Or just follow LIGO on Twitter. Right now, there are gravitational waves passing through your body. The distortions of space-time rippling outwards in all directions from mass moving through space, stretching and contracting you. It's only been 2 years since astronomers detected them for the first time and only found a handful. Now, we'll learn of dozens every year, different varieties of collisions happening farther and farther out into the universe. The age of gravitational astronomy has truly begun. What do you think? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Once a week, I gather up all my space news into a single email newsletter and send it out. It's got pictures, brief highlights about the story, and links so that you can find out more. Go to universetoday.com/newsletter to sign up. Did you know that all of my videos are also available in a handy audio podcast format so that you can have the latest episodes show up right on your audio device? Go to universetoday.com/audio or search for Universe Today on iTunes, Spotify, or whatever you get your podcasts, and I'll put a link in the show notes. And finally, here's a playlist.